ونزلنا من السماء ماء مباركا فأنبتنا به جنات وحب الحصيد ونزلنا من السماء ماء مباركا فأنبتنا به جنات وحب الحصيد ونزلنا من السماء ماء مباركا فأنبتنا به جنات وحب الحصيد ونزلنا من السماء ماء مباركا فأنبتنا به جنات وحب الحصيد ونزلنا من السماء ماء مباركا فأنبتنا به جنات وحب الحصيد
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome back. سورة قاف chapter number 50 but this time verse number 9. Once again Allah the Almighty is showing us and particularly those who deny His Lordship that He is the only Creator by guiding us to things that we see on a regular basis. How He creates the produce, what we eat and without it life will vanish. So the Almighty says in verse number 9, وَنَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً مُبَارَكًا فَأَنْبَتْنَا بِهِ جَنَّاتٍ وَحَبَّ الْحَصِيدِ He says, as a reminder, we have sent down blessed rain from the sky and made grow thereby gardens and grains from the harvest. The grains like the barley, like the wheat, like the rice, we eat some, we feed the cattle some, and we use some to regrow them. Then when Allah the Almighty sends down the rain, and He described it as ma'an mubarakan, blessed water. You know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever it rains, he used to supplicate. And he used to say, you know, this is the time where the dua will be answered. Because when Allah sends down the rain, that means He is pleased with us. He is ready to accept our supplication. And He used to go out in the rain and expose His body to the rain and says, it has come fresh from Allah, it is pure. So Allah described it as ma'an mubarakan. With this water, with this blessed water, Allah revives the earth after it was barren. And that's why if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were to withhold the rain, life will stop. Livestock will vanish. Human beings will die as a result of the drought. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prescribed for us salat al-istisqa, a prayer of seeking the rain. We go out, We turn our clothes inside, outside, and we beg Allah for forgiveness, and we ask Him for His pardon. We beg Him to send down the rain so that He will send down the rain as a mercy from the Almighty. In Surah Al-Hajj, verse number 5, it begins with when Allah the Almighty says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَبٍ مِّنَ الْبَعْثِ. O people, if you are doubting resurrection, let me tell you. Then He reminds us how He created us from turab, then from nutfa, then from alaqa, the different stages of the creation in the womb, after conception, after Allah created Adam from dust. Then He said, this is similar to وَتَرَى الْأَرْضَ هَامِدَةً فَإِذَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ اهْتَزَّتْ وَرَبَتْ وَأَنبَتَتْ مِن كُلِّ زَوْجٍ بَهِيجٍ. You see the barren land, dead. Then when Allah the Almighty sends down the blessed rain, أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْهَا الْمَاءَ, produces all kind of fruits, trees, grains, اهتزت وربت, it flourishes and it turns green, وأنبتت من كل زوج بهيج, of every pair of the fruits, the vegetables, the trees, the grains, pleasing to people, not only to the farmers, because we all eat out of that and we feed our livestock, so we survive. ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأنه يحيي الموتى. That is because Allah is the ultimate truth. He is the only one who created, and He is the only one who is worthy of worship, and He is the only one who will bring the dead back to life. وَأَنَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. And indeed, He is able to do all things. He is the only one who is worthy of worship accordingly. May Allah guide us what is best. Until next time, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.